I know Mykelti's trying very hard to have these vaginally, and I'm all for that because I've had a C-section and the recovery is very hard from it. The vaginal birth is better at home or without the painkillers. I know it sounds hard, but the recovery is 10 times easier. And when you have C-section, I mean, they've basically cut open your abdomen. So they've cut all those muscles. So think about anytime you turn in bed or you try to sit up or any kind of movement, and it's really miserable.
So are you okay with that?
I'll get over it.
I'm sorry.
Better a scar than a scarred kid.
Yeah, that's a good way to phrase it.
Losing the chance to be able to hold my child first thing right on my chest in my arms is something that I'm just having a hard time with.
I don't know if it's a cultural thing. I don't know if it's a polygamous thing. I don't really know, but I was always raised that natural home births were the best way to go. I loved the recovery of the home birth. It was wonderful. Also, an epidural, though, kicks butt. So, you know, it's a tough call. Mykelti likes as natural as possible, and the girl's as tough as it gets.
We can't change reality, but we can change what our expectations are, okay?
I'll take the safer option.
Okay, sounds good.
It is what it is. And I'd rather my kids be safe and healthy and me be safe and healthy versus the possibility of something wrong happening.
I prefer home births to hospital births. Most births are just natural. It's a very natural experience. Birthing is very natural.
So we can't be in there if it's a C-section.
No.
We'll be like in the waiting room, right?
Yeah. Every extra person that's in the OR, it's an infection risk. And so that's why they don't let, you know, your favorite mother.
It's interesting.
Awkward.
But not that it wasn't awkward during your delivery when questions were being asked about.
Oh, yeah, that was funny. Yeah.
Hopefully we see you in 6 days. Hopefully not sooner.
I know.
6 days.
I'm excited for you.
Me too.
Okay.
Please. Thank you.
So I'm hoping that everything goes right. Everything's good. I don't need to see Dr. Bean until then, because that means that everything's going right if I don't have to see my doctor.
Today is the day before the twins are going to be born. They're going to be born tomorrow. Isn't it so weird you can schedule a day for a birth?
I'm excited for these little babies to come. Really excited.
This is a really big deal to me, and I'm excited to be there and be grandma and just support them through this.
How are you feeling there?
I'm good.
I'm excited. I'm ready.
I'm hoping Christine's cool and easy about this, too. I don't want any drama. I don't want any stress. I mean, I care about Christine. I want her to be happy, and I respect and honor her position as Mykelti's mother.
I'm ready to be done.
Whoop, whoop.
Forever. This is the last time we're going to see you pregnant.
Yes, this is the last time I will ever, hopefully, knock on wood, this is the last time I will ever be pregnant again.
I love the idea of, in the future, maybe having more kids, but they will not come out of my body. Pregnancy is miserable. It is literally awful.
You look really good. How many, what are you
measuring? So I am currently 38 weeks tomorrow exactly. But the size, the mass of my stomach last week was measuring 52 weeks. It's all baby belly. Like the doctor measures from the bottom of the baby to the very top where he can't feel the kid anymore, like all the way. And you have 52 weeks. Just so you guys know, for recovery purposes, that means I do actually have to recover an extra 12 weeks outside of what a 40-week pregnancy has to.
Are you serious?
Yeah, because it's bigger. So the recovery is harder for twins.
I've watched her during the pregnancy be this strong woman who is in very flexible and very good shape, can climb the stairs with the Avalon and stuff in her arms. And I think if anyone could do it, she can do it. And I'm all for her trying.
Both boys are feet down, which means breech. So their heads are actually, there's a head right here and there's a head right here. And because their heads are up, I can't deliver them through my vagina. I have to actually get cut open. But they're both healthy. They're going to be healthy.
Oh, yeah.
We'll be able to hold them.
We'll be able to hold them.
Yeah.
But if he tried to deliver the first, so if the first kid, baby A, was head down and baby B was breech, which would be the second kid that comes out, he'd be willing to risk delivering the second kid breech, meaning the doctor, because it's a little bit more, the kid's already slid it out of there once, like it's a little bit more positive that it'll be okay. But since both are breech, it's just a little bit too scary to try to deliver them feet first.
And even if one was the right way, he would have to reach in and spin the other one to get that one out, is risky and hurts a lot, so.
But epidural, I've come to terms with it. Like, I'm gonna get over the fact that I can't have them vaginally, but I'm not too happy about it.
But you'll be able to see it too, we were saying.
Yeah,
it's not the cloth here though, right?
Sorry. So I'll have a curtain. I'll have a curtain over in front of my face, so I won't be able to see them actually do the procedure. But Dr. Bean did say that he would put a mirror down there, so if I wanted to, I could.
Why?
Why not?
Sign me up for that too.
Put you in like so cool. Rest,
I want to see it because if I can't feel it, I want to at least know what's going on. They have to like cut layers by layers too, because they got to cut the muscle and the like the skin, and then they've got to cut the uterine wall. And it just sounds so cool. a little gruesome.
I wonder how Avalon's gonna react.
She's gonna have siblings, plural. Yeah,
it'd be great. And no one's ever left out with three kids. No one's ever left out. There's always someone.
She'll be left out a lot. They're twins. They can stick together. I'm really excited about tomorrow. The next time you see me, I won't be pregnant.
Weird.
I'm ready to give birth. I'm feeling good. I feel like I didn't sleep at all last night. Anticipation the next day, sleep's not gonna happen.
They came in, they kind of prepped Mykelti, talked to her, and then they put Tony in this, like, looked like a beekeeper suit from like head to toe.
Tony's nervous. He's really nervous. They put him in a suit.
You know, we gave Mykelti our hugs and kisses and told her we loved her, and she was willed away.
It's hard. It's really hard emotionally to have your kids have any kind of procedure like that. It was really difficult.
The entire pregnancy, my heart rate never spiked. I never had issues with blood pressure at all. But as soon as I was in there getting the numbing for the epidural and then getting the epidural, my heart rate started spiking and my blood pressure started going up and I started to go into a panic. I am extremely upset that I can't have Tony in the operating room with me while I get the epidural. The doctors and the nurses in the room were like, something's going on, what's wrong? My body was shaking just because I was just anxiety. There's the only solution is get me my husband. As soon as Tony entered the room though, he was finally able to come in and immediately I started to calm down. I started to feel better because I had him there.
You just trust in these doctors so much that everything's gonna be okay. I was really glad Aspen was there. Robin was there in the room too, so the three of us just sat and waited for it to be done.
It's just surprising, a little scary, what it takes to get those babies out of her. I was really happy I could be there during the operation because I know it means the world to her and I want to be there. Seeing everything, really cool. Being there for my wife, super, super important. Having kids come back, best part.
When I have Archer in my arms, I just instantly start calming down and everything's fine. And then Ace comes out, they wrap him up a little bit and then they bring him over in my other arm and I'm able to hold him. And at that point, I'm like, this is great. I'm happy. This is awesome. Yes. You'd hear the voices of my mom's and Aspen in the other room. It was just like this an incredible experience. I had my boys, they were safe, they were here, they were healthy, and it was just this just overjoyous experience of everything's fine.